authorized to watch this video.
I get Batak! Blizzard Attack! There's some good show-off potential with this weapon, but using Blizzard Attack is a lot like juggling frozen vegetables. It can be quite cucumbersome. Ah, looky here, Blizzard, Plant, Flame Man, all stages that have just one path. We starting to see a pattern now? Of course we are, I just told it to you. Wait a second, that's the British spelling of defense. Unless C is for centaur, in which case, that's good enough for me. Oh boy, I finally get to play with the kiddie pool! Kiddie pool, kiddie pool, what else could this possibly be? I mean, really, what else could it possibly be? You'll see me fumble here for a second with the little mini cutscene here. Actually, if you hold down start the whole blam time, blam, you'll blam, be able to skip that and blam entirely. I love this.
Try not to burn up in re-entry.
Ooh! I love the way this stage turned out. It makes me really happy. The giddy kind of happy, as you can tell, clearly. Yes. Now, I've noticed that this weapon is one of those rare barriers that's actually better offensively than defensively, considering how it did not protect me last stage. And I love this. I love this. I am platonically in love with the performance on this stage. Sorry, I got carried away. You may find yourself using a Blizzard Attack, and you may find yourself in another part of the world with a robotic dog and 4 extra lives. And you may ask yourself, well, why did he do that? Don't you touch those spikes? Water flowing overhead as the stage goes by. This trap is never used again. Shame that it never was. What do you mean, bah? Yeah, that's exactly what I'm asking about. You mean I'm not allowed to slide in my power suit? It's not like it's an Armani. Oh yeah, this weapon. Remember when I used to use the charge shot before Mega Man 9 took it away? Before I got special weapons? Hey! That sounded useful! Wow! Eddie's being uncharacteristically helpful this game. So you can tell we're in Greece, because Greece is surrounded by water, and pillars were the foundation of ancient Greece, and flying, cloud-covered submarines are the backbone of the Greek Navy?
Awesome!
Oh, and they're centaurs. This just makes me happy. Sploosh! You may need to pardon my enthusiasm on this stage, it's just that I finally have a lot of fun special weapons that are really cool to show off with. Yeah! What's more, this stage is complex and diverse enough in its challenges to offer me a wide variety of options when it comes to showing off. So here, for example, I can
leap tall squids in a single bound!
I can do all sorts of fun stuff. I'm only limited by my imagination. Duh. Now look at this, I'm at the end of the stage, and now we get a split path? This is supposed to be replayability? Play the exact same stage twice, fight the same boss twice in 2 different places! Woohoo! Yeah, I'm not so excited, but you know what I am excited about?
Video editing. So cool!
Yeah, so I was at the top, now I'm down at the bottom, so I'll show you what this area looks like, and then I will suddenly switch to the top when you most expect it. You may be wondering why I'm using Night Crush against Centaur Man? Well, if a scary man came charging at you, wouldn't you pull out your mace? Did you see that finishing move? I am never that good at fighting Centaur Man. What is going on? Oh, what is going on? Where am I? Alright, video editing. So I escaped from Centaur Man without being scarred because he didn't flash me and freeze me in place, and he didn't do his teleportation shtick. So to celebrate, we can take a shot. Or, if you prefer, we can have a tea partsy. Mmm, beauty parts. Now, finally, Centaur.
Flash.
Centaur.
Flash.
What is that?
Flash.
Who's doing that?
Flash.
Stop it! As I was saying, now I have Centaur Flash, and it's a really great weapon. It's one of my all-time favorite Mega Man weapons. This weapon is where it's at. It obliterates, or at least dings up, everything on the screen using relatively little weapon energy, considering what it does. Ah, now to the American West, where... Oh, restricted area. Forget it. Never mind. Oh, wait, we have clearance. We do have clearance to be here, right? This is what Hardman stage might have looked like if Mega Man 3 had been released a couple of years later. It's amazing how far the graphics have come in this series. Every installment just keeps looking better and better. Ooh, E-Tank. Finally, my obsessive block-breaking habits have paid off. Don't get used to it. I'll admit, that was a fairly cleverly hidden E-Tank. Don't do that to me. You scared me. Ah, want a mid-air showdown, do you? Nice. The trouble with energy tanks in this game is that, like the 1-ups in Mega Man 5, they're ever so slightly too plentiful. Also, most of them are really easy to get. I feel like energy tanks should be a reward, something you earn. They're too valuable to just give away.
Congratulations, you got out of bed. Here's a Fabergé egg.
It's too easy. Like that. Who knew you could jam up a hard hat dispenser with plants? This game is weird. You may also be wondering why I call them hard hats and not their other name. Well, all it would take would be one time of me shouting, "Oh, I hate those Mets," for a bunch of New Yorkers to get upset. But I don't need them and the Canadians angry at me. Whoa, did you see that? One snowflake bounced off and bumped off that hard hat. Wow!
Energy!
E is for easy, you're too good at your job, Flip-Top, you're part of the problem, not part of the solution, thank you. Hey, that's pretty. Check it out. They added ridges to Mega Man's helmet. Also, a sunset. Here's a prime example of an enemy-based challenge. Without the enemies, or arguably even with them, there's no challenge, which is why I'm leading these Skullwalkers to a photo opportunity.
Say, Fuzzy Pickles.
Aw, that was a perfect place for
Flash.
To do that and get it out of our system.
Flame. Flame.
Come to think of it, this has been a rather musical video. Don't expect any more singing, though, like what happened in Centaur Man stage. That kind of thing is once in a lifetime. See what I did there? Here's a challenge. Hover in the sun. Not only is it really good practice with the jetpack, but it looks pretty cool.
Invisible ceiling.
Also cool, the jetpack detail when Mega Man's hunched over the ladder. It's the little things. It looks like my flying energy recharges when I land, except I think my fuel line might be jammed. I'm losing altitude.
Sorry, I was just looking at my watch to see what time it was. Did something exciting just happen? No?
Here we are, back at the split. Looks exactly the way I left it. Good to know some things never change. It's interesting, at least the way I play, that Blizzard is a more defensive weapon than Plant. Blizzard's good for enemies who are trying to sneak up on you, whereas Plant is good for haphazardly ramming into things. Considering how quickly the flame towers dissipate, it's usually more effective to hit an enemy directly than to launch a fireball at the floor and say, "Come on, boy, run into the flame!" Well, that was quick, and also very fun. It's neat when the special weapons make you feel powerful. Here's another split path requiring jet adapter. Here's me scraping my helmet across the ceiling. Here's me throwing myself off a cliff.
Nice recovery.
It's getting a little crowded.
Guess I better do something about it. This screen ain't big enough for the five of us.
Not bad, considering the last time I tried a cowboy voice, I sounded like a gnome with spurs. This is where the alternate paths get a little too tricky for their own good. If you go left, you can get a very important item. If you go right, you get another beat part. Decisions, decisions, to backtracking. This is curious. I can see a lot of potential applications for this kind of not enemy, but unfortunately that's almost the only time it shows up in the entire game. Imagine scattering a bunch of them around a vertical area and trying to make your way to the top. Well, that was disconcerting. The thing about Mega Man 6 is it's not as creative about the quantity, placement, and combination of enemies and traps as some of the other games. Nudge, nudge. And this, nudge, nudge, is really tricky, because you need to charge up your power punch, nudge, and get close enough to break the block without falling into the happy pit. The latter might be safer. It's Pointless Cameo Man! And he left us a thing! I'm more interested in the wall. Nah, there's nothing over here. Okay, I'll take it. It's an energy balancer, or energy equalizer if you prefer. They don't tell you this in-game, of course, but after I'm done gleefully swinging back and forth, I'll tell you what it does. In the meantime... Whee! Oh, you notice I went up a pixel there? I should have kept falling. Anyways, the energy balancer will automatically refill the weapon with the lowest amount of energy whenever you pick up a weapon capsule, if you're playing as normal Jet or Power Mega Man. Saves time, less waste. Hey, I missed.
No, I totally didn't miss. That was all coordinated, haha.
I love how I can go from professional textbook to terminal goofball in all of 2 seconds. At last, the moment you have been waiting for. Once more, the eternal drama will unfold of Plant versus Tomahawk.
Look at how much bigger he is and how much more detail he has. And he's relentless, too. He might just be the toughest robot master in the game because he does not give you a chance to breathe.
Plant wins.
If you've got his timing down, maintaining a moderate distance should help you avoid a bad case of Tomahawk face. Oh, and I'm not going to bother to show you the alternate boss chamber because, unless I'm mistaken, it's exactly the same.
Oh, here he comes, look out!
I'll be honest, every time I play this game, when he shoots at me, I dodge out of the way! Or I put a pillow in front of my face to block the shot. Whoops, I didn't get beat B parts because I forgot to switch to the alternate chamber. So I'll go do that off camera eventually, but first I'm gonna go break Windman.